Hey everyone, my name is Razvan. I'm a quality assurance automation engineer, and in this tutorial we are going to talk about Selenium Grid. Let's start with a theoretical part followed by a practical example. So, what is Selenium Grid? As you can see in my presentation, Selenium Grid is a part of Selenium Suite that helps us running multiple tests across different browsers, operating systems, and machines in parallel. Selenium Grid is used when we want to save time and effort for execution, or we want to run our tests simultaneously against different machines, operating systems, and browsers. Selenium Grid has two versions. The Grid 1.0, it has its own remote control, requires installation and configuration of ANT, can only support Selenium RC command scripts. We can automate only one browser per remote control. And also we have the Grid 2.0, which is bundled with Selenium server jar file. It doesn't require ANT, supports both Selenium RC commands and web driver scripts, and we can automate up to 5 browsers per remote control. Let's talk about its architecture. Selenium Grid contains one hub and at least one node. The hub works as a central point and controls all the nodes, and each node is a Selenium instance that will execute the tests. The node can be launched on multiple machines with different platforms and browsers. For example, in our image, the node 1 represents the Edge browser, which runs on Windows 10. The node 2 has a Safari on Mac. Node 3 has a Chrome on Linux, and Node 4 represents an Android or iOS platform. Notice should be the fact that the test suite is stored on the machine that contains the hub, and the tests are being executed on the node machines. Starting the hub and the nodes implies a couple of commands. Starting the hub will be always on the 4444 port, but we can specify a different one by adding an additional parameter, hyphen port 4441, for example. We can also verify the used port using the following terminal command, netstat hyphen a. Before starting the node, we have to make sure that the hub is up and running. Looking at the command used to starting the node, we will see that one of its parameters refers to the WebDriver Chrome driver, which tells us that we are going to use a WebDriver Chrome in our tests, and it equals to its path. A second parameter of this command is hyphen hub HTTP localhost grid register. Basically, this parameter links our node to the hub. Selenium Grid provides a grid console, which is a web interface application. In this image, we see that we have a node. This is its address. And the node contains one Internet Explorer, 5 Firefox browsers, and 5 Chrome browsers. These are code snippets used to create tests that are being executed on a remote web driver instead of our local Chrome driver. And let's go to the example. Before we start coding, we need to start the hub, and I will use a command line going to the Selenium server jar file. And the command is java-jar selenium jar file -role hub. And we can see that the Selenium Grid Hub is up and running. We will do the same thing in order to start the node. CMD, go to path. And the command is java-d webdriver chrome driver equals its path. chrome.driver.exe hyphen jar selenium jar file hyphen role, which is a node in our case, hyphen hub, and we're going to use this address. Nodes should register to. Okay, so it basically links our node to this hub. Okay, enter. The node is registered to the hub and ready to use. In the hub terminal, we see a new line of code which says registered a node on this address. So this is the address of our node. Let's go to the Eclipse. This is a sample project which has its jars already included, jars like Java client, Selenium Java, and testng. And now we are going to create a new class file. Let's name it SG, Selenium Grid. We are not going to check the public static void main because we are going to use the testng notations. Let's define the web driver and define a new string variable in which we will store the node address. Let's create a test method. In which we will assert the title of a website, let's say. Assert title. Let's add the testng annotation, but we need to import it, and we also need to import the WebDriver library. Let's create a desired capabilities object. I think it's a typo. Okay. Let's set the browser and the platform that we are going to use. Chrome and set platform dot Windows 10. In our case, let's get back to the driver. New remote web driver. We will need to include this library. It receives two parameters. The first one will be a new URL, and the second one will be the capability object. We need to import a URL, and this URL receives a parameter which will be our node URL variable. Okay, and I forgot to pass a value to this variable. Note URL equals to the address of our node, which is this one. And we need to also add a WD slash hub. We need to handle an exception. In this example, I will use the add truth declaration. Let's add to our driver an implicit weight and a maximize. Let's say 10 seconds, time unit seconds. Okay, and maximize. Okay, great. Let's access using the driver an URL, driver.get. Let's say gmail.com. Let's create a new string current title. Driver.getTitle. And let's create a new variable called expected. Equal Gmail value. Okay, let's make an assert. And I assert that the current title is the same one as the expected one. And we need to close the browser. Now we need to run the script using the testng framework, and let's see what happens. You need to observe that instead of a Chrome driver, we used the remote web driver, which points to this node address, to this terminal. As soon as we run the script, we should get some logs into the node terminal. And we get the logs, we get the browser. It accesses the Gmail and it asserts the title. And total test run 1. And assert title test has passed. Okay guys, so that's all I have for this video. Thanks for watching, and please like and subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Happy testing!